Update 19 went live today in Fallout 76, and we're going to go over all the details coming up next. Hey everyone, it's Jeremy from JMK3 Gaming with another Fallout 76 video. Today on May 19th, 2020, Update 19 went live, and there's some good bits to go over. Some of the highlights include ally customization, where we're going to be able to give our allies some new looks, a couple new events called Hunt for the Treasure Hunter, and the Fashnod Parade is back, item naming updates, backpack updates, and some nuclear winter updates for those who actually play that. Before we get too far into it, don't forget to hit that like button. If you're new to the channel, subscribe. We put out new content regularly for Fallout 76. And don't forget to check us out on Twitch. We stream every Monday, Wednesday, Friday at 9 p.m. Eastern. Okay, so part of this update is we get to customize our allies. So according to the patch notes, starting today, you can now share your wardrobe with your allies and swap their outfits to your heart's content with ally customization. When interacting with an ally in your camp, a new customize option will now appear that you can use to change their clothing. Outfits, headwear, costumes, armor. If you can wear it, then so can your ally. The only current exceptions are power armor and weapons. Additionally, when viewing another player's ally, its name will be adjusted to include the name of the camp's owner. Please note that scrapping an ally station will revert that ally to their default outfit. Allies will also appear to be in their default outfit if they are in an instance with you. Hunt for the Treasure Hunter. Mole miners are searching for riches around Appalachia, and you can hunt them down to claim their loot for yourself in a new series of limited-time Hunt for the Treasure Hunter events we're introducing with Update 19. Use your keen tracking senses to hunt down Treasure Hunter mole miners to collect their mole miner pails, which contain all of the loot they've been hoarding. Treasure Hunter mole miners are legendary creatures, and you will hear them when they're nearby. Treasure Hunter mole miners can drop rewards from one of three different tiers: Dusty Mole Miner Pails, Mole Miner Pails, and Ordnance Mole Miner Pails. The higher quality the pail, the better chances are for rare loot, including outfits, mounting head plans, a new backpack plan, and the Marine Armor Helmet plan. Pails can also be traded and sold to other players, but cannot be sold to NPC vendors. And while a Treasure Hunter event is live, vendors around Appalachia will sell empty Mole Miner Pails in exchange for caps, so we can craft our own Mole Miner Pails. Head to the Ash Heap on May 21st. The first Hunt for the Treasure Hunter event will take place from May 21st to May 25th in the Ash Heap region of Appalachia. Future Hunt for the Treasure Hunter events will occur in a different region. The Fashnot Parade marches back to Helvetia. Starting next week, you can travel to Helvetia to take part in the Fashnot seasonal event by helping the local Protectrons prepare the town's annual celebration and parade. Basically, it's the same as last year's Fashnot. You do a bunch of tasks for the bots. The more marchers who survive the event, the higher your chances at rare loot, which may include Fashnot-themed camp plans and a chance to earn a fancy Fashnot mask. We've added a number of festive new masks this year and adjusted their drop rates following community feedback. While some are still less common than others, they should drop more often this time. You can also trade your Fashnot mask to other players. Successfully guide the marchers to the end of the parade route and you'll be rewarded with loot. Fashnot Parade will begin every hour at the top of the hour starting on May 25th. The event will last for a full week, so you'll have plenty of chances to join in the celebration. There have been some new design updates, automatic name improvements. With this update, we've improved how the game automatically names your weapons and armors based on their mods, legendary attributes, and atomic shot paints. Going forward, automatically generated names will appear in a much more consistent order, and they will reliably include an item's main attributes. Additionally, atomic shot paint and skin names no longer overwrite the item's primary legendary effect name. Items should now generally follow this naming convention: primary legendary attribute plus atomic shot cosmetic name plus mod name plus weapon name. So, if you have a legendary Gatling gun with the Black Knight paint and a prime receiver, its automatically generated name should be Anti-Armor Black Knight Prime Gatling Gun. That's a mouthful. So keep in mind that you can still give your items custom names, which will override their automatically generated names. Please note that given the many combinations that are possible through all the different mods, legendary effects, atomic shop paints, and item types, there are many cases where new item names appear incorrect. Backpack appearance updates. We've improved backpack customization so that you can now apply different appearances to your backpacks as skins. No more crafting required. Head to an armor workbench and use the modify menu to swap the appearance of your existing backpack with any skins you've unlocked through quests, events, or the atomic shop. If you haven't completed the Order of the Tadpole quest line, skins can now be applied to small backpacks as well. Art and animation get some updates as well. The barbecue grills. If you get hungry when using a barbecue grill, your character will now appear to flip and grill some tasty steaks. Yeah, just in time for summer. Grognak's throne. We've added a new animation that will play when sitting on the throne so that you can survey your land with royal confidence. Some item updates. The Liberty Prime power armor. If you're a strong silent type, you may be pleased to know that we've added an alternate version of the Liberty Prime power armor helmet that will not play voice lines when you're wearing it. Players who own the Liberty Prime power armor can now craft the silent version of the helmet at a power armor station. Nuclear Winter gets some updates. The Limited Time Survivors Challenge unlocked themed cosmetics. We've added 8 Nuclear Winter challenges that you can complete to earn new Survivors themed cosmetic rewards starting today and lasting until 7 p.m. Eastern on June 11th. One new challenge will appear in the Character Challenge menu each day until 8 are available, and they will remain available until the end of the event. Overseer XP you earn will roll over from one challenge to the next, but they must be completed one at a time and in order. You can learn more about this event directly from Zax and preview the rewards by reading our latest Zax Transmission article on Fallout.com. You can earn the first reward with 150 Overseer XP and the last with 2,500 Overseer XP. All others will each require 2,000 Overseer XP. As you complete each challenge, you will be able to claim new themed rewards like new furniture for your camp, Survivor's Denim, as well as skins for Nuclear Winter's newest weapons, the Bow, Cattle Prod, and Goss Shotgun. There's some new items for Nuclear Winter. The Bow, Cattle Prod, and Goss Shotgun have been added and tuned for combat in Nuclear Winter matches. Find them in supply crates as you scavenge for gear. There were a bunch of bug fixes as well with the art and animation, camp and workshops, combat, enemies, challenges, and items, NPCs, performance and stability, quest and events, sound, user interface, the world, and Nuclear Winter bug fixes. So some of them of note are in combat, the stealth. Receiving stealth from multiple sources at once, like the Escape Artist Perk card, Stealth Boys, Chameleon Armor, etc., no longer causes enemies to instantly detect the player. And VATS, when changing the body parts selection in VATS while using charged weapons like the bow or Goss weapon, no longer causes the next shot to hit the previously selected body part. The Blood Eagles are no longer going to drop weapons that have Nuclear Winter mods in them. The Wendigo Colossus, so they fixed an issue that could cause the Wendigo Colossus to suddenly stop taking damage. In the challenges, the Luz Mine, Foundation, and Crater now have locations that are considered subterranean for challenges like level up in caves and mines. For the items, I know one that were a lot of people were talking about was the Secret Service Under Armor. That's been corrected, so you can now craft them under Under Armor. They also fixed the Gatling guns in the Pip-Boy, so they're now going to correctly display a fire rate of 20. Other than that, they seem to have fixed a lot of the exploits, although it seems that the vending machines are still down. So as an update, this one's not bad. It's just a normal update that had some maintenance going on with it. The ally customization's nice. You know, it just makes it a little more homey, I guess. I got a little tired of looking at the Commander Daguerre standing around in her spacesuit. All I had available was a lab coat, so into the lab coat she went. Some new events, you know, that's always nice to have. A little more content just to give a little more rewards. Coming in with seasonal, I think that's going to be a pretty good theme going on here in Fallout 76. The backpack update's nice. I did buy the skin, the clandestine skin, and then I put it on my alt. He didn't do the Order of the Tadpole and he couldn't craft it. I was so pissed. I mean, all in all, there's nothing really major here. It's probably just stuff that's they've had ready to go ahead of the big update 20 coming that'll release the seasonal progression. So, I mean, some of this with the recurring themes is just getting us ready for seasons. I'm going to do another video on seasons because there's so much to talk about with that roadmap. And I think a lot of what was published is more misleading than they really want us to believe. So I'm just been working on a real in-depth, true meaning of the roadmap. So stay tuned for that. That should be coming later this week. And that's going to do it for Update 19. Let me know in the comments what you think. Are you ready to give your allies some new looks, even though they really won't get any buffs in combat? Looking forward to some new events? Foshnot's back. That's pretty exciting. Let me know if you plan on participating. As always, thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more Fallout 76 content. This is Jeremy for JMK3 Gaming, and have a great one.